Hello everybody, today I'm going to show you how to fix Fallout 3 from crashing on your Windows 7. All you're going to need is a simple DLL file, and then we're going to have to edit a little file for Fallout 3. So first, go to the internet and go to the link that I provide you in the description below. Then you're going to download this DLL file and just save it to a nice place. And then you're going to go to your Fallout 3 directory. Mine is a computer, H, games, Fallout 3. And then once you're here, you're gonna place the DLL file right here. It might say it's a virus, but it's not. I promise it's not a virus. All it does is it basically forces DirectX to work on Fallout 3. So after you place it right here, it'll basically allow DirectX to use the full capability of Fallout 3. The next thing you have to do, if this doesn't work, you try to go into Fallout 3 and it crashes. It's basically, we're gonna go to your start documents, my games, and Fallout 3, and then you're gonna go to our Fallout folder. Well, we're in the Fallout folder, but we're gonna go to this text file right here. We're gonna double click on it, and it basically will bring up the setup for Fallout 3, all of the commands, how it loads, and stuff like that. We just have to modify one line of code and add another one. Basically, we're gonna press Control and F, and we're gonna find this command basically. Okay, so after you find it, it is bUseThreadedAI equals 0. You have to change it to 1. So basically, 0 to 1. Then you're gonna press Enter. It's gonna go to another blank line. And then from the description, you're gonna paste this one. So you paste that, and it basically what it does is it makes use of all your threads, and it limits the CPU to use 2 cores. So it basically doesn't crash or your Fallout 3, because Fallout 3 like doesn't get enough memory, and then it just crashes. Like you play, and then one time it freezes. So after you do these things, you're gonna press File, Save. You just have to save it, or it's not gonna save, and you know it won't work. You're gonna close all this, and basically that's it. You're gonna go to Fallout 3, try to play a new game, load a game, and see if it works. It should work actually, but if it doesn't work, just leave me a comment in the description, and I'm gonna try to help you out. Or just search on Google if you still doesn't work, but this is the most common way. This is the way that worked for me. I tried a lot of fixes, and this one's the best one. And just a little pro tip for you, if you're downloading it from the internet, never download rips, because especially there's a popular rip for Fallout 3, but it doesn't work for Windows 7, so just download the full ISO and install it. Then it's gonna work. Don't download all these rips or you know fancy releases. Just download the full game, and that's it. So that's how you do it, guys. If you like this video, please rate, comment, subscribe. If you want more follow videos or whatever videos you want, then please leave me a comment and send me a message. So thanks for watching. Peace out. Goodbye.